Alright, very short video to talk about the cut utility, which is mainly used to, like, when you have multiple fields in a text file, and so you want to go line by line in a text file, and the file has multiple fields, like a CSV file, or a file that is a space separated fields, which is very common in Unix files. That's the utility you can use to pick which file you want and kind of filter them. And yeah, I'm just making this video because I see a lot of scripts that use like awk or sed or complex utilities to do this kind of thing. But actually there is a very small one called cut, which you can use. And yeah, you have to remember that whenever you use utilities that are more targeted toward the very specific tasks, this means that this utility is probably faster than the more complex ones, you know, because awk is a full language and sed also is like Turing complete. So that's a bit overkill. But anyway, so let's say, for example, you want to parse a bit the itsy shells file because, I don't know, it has path and you want to know like the base or something, I don't know. So what you can do is use cut and you say F for field and you say you can pick the field that you want. So let's say I want the second field, which will be bin, and you say you press specify a delimiter, which will be slash in our case, and you then specify the file you want to parse. And as you can see, it took only the second field. Knowing that the first field is like the string that is before the first slash, you know, if you use the field delimiter slash. And so you can do this. You can also specify multiple fields with a comma separated list. You can specify like ranges. So you can say from the second onward, or you can say, from the first to the third one, like so. You can also specify S to only print the lines that have the delimiter in them. So you see that the top comments were ignored. You can specify ranges and index. You can specify multiple ranges. I mean, in this case, it doesn't matter too much, but yeah. And so that's basically all there is to know about the fields one. You can just, yeah, or like, or not, I don't know, to parse like the etsy password file. It's quite useful. And all other kinds of, yeah, regular files. It also works on bytes and characters. So if you can say character, and I want, let's say, the 10th first character, but I also want the 15 until last on etsy shells, and you can see that it's a bit weird, but basically it cut like 5 characters in the middle of it. Maybe if I do something like 6 and then it will be a bit clearer. Like okay, that's something you would never do, but if your file is organized if you know you want to match on characters, you can do this. You can also do it on bytes if you want. So yeah, if you're working maybe with binary files, it can be useful. Well, binary files that have multiple lines, that's a bit strange, but anyway, it does come handy from time to time, the B and C option. But yeah, that's about it. And all otherwise people do like awk, and I don't even remember, like print one, I think, something like that. Well, that wouldn't work in shells. Then they have to specify some like delimiter, like so is equal to I'm sure you've, it's not del, it's something else, I forgot, but this pattern that I see often when you can just use cut. So yeah, that's about it, and yeah, see you in the next one.